Also developing tonight, the government releasing stark new numbers from the crisis on our southern border. The Border Patrol says more than 55,000 unaccompanied children have been detained since October. That is up 500% from this time last year. But while the administration says it was caught off guard by all of this, our next guest says the president has been planning this border breakdown for years. Dinesh D'Souza is a documentary filmmaker and creator of the new hit film America. Dinesh, good to see you. And I know actually you had a meeting on your own book being booted out of Costco with Costco today. We're going to get to that in a moment. But let's start with your theory that President Obama wanted this border chaos. Why?
Well, Megan, start by asking this. You have hordes of people who are showing up at the border, women and children with sick and hungry. Now, why is this happening now? You can't say it's because there's poverty and need around the world, because there's been poverty and need around the world since the time of the Babylonians. So why is this occurring now? Are there revolutions swirling across Central America that are coughing up refugees? No, nothing has changed over there. What has changed is over here. The Obama administration for the past 6 years has been signaling that it's not serious about enforcing the immigration laws, that it doesn't particularly care to police the border very tightly, and moreover, that it wants to have amnesty at home so that lawbreakers within this country get a break. So those messages eventually filter to people in other countries, and they go, gee, well, if those guys aren't particularly vigilant about their border, it's going to be a chance for us to get across.
Right. Well,
and so I think
this.
Let me
ask you this, because the president, the White House, they would obviously point to the fact that they say they have record numbers of deportations. Some have questioned those numbers, but they say that they have removed far more illegal immigrants than George Bush did, for example. But let's put that to the side. If your theory is correct, why? Why would the president want this to happen?
Think of it this way. The main opposition to amnesty is the Republicans, who I think very sensibly say, listen, if you want to discuss how we should deal with our immigration problem at home, let's first lock the border. You can't have a porous border and at the same time be debating the issue. Let's close the border, and then let's, as a country, get together and sensibly debate, what do we do with the illegals who are here? Obama says, okay, how do I thwart that strategy? Now, one of the lessons of Obama's political mentor, this is the radical activist Saul Alinsky, was that, look, the American middle class is fundamentally innocent and decent, and you can always exploit the natural goodness of the American middle class for political ends. So if you produce women and children sick, starving, in desperate need at the border, it's very difficult for the ordinary American goodwill to say, turn those people back. Sorry, we're not going to help you out. So just by preying on the goodness of the American people, Obama's able to force the hand of the on the immigration issue and put the Republicans on the defensive and say, listen, either you give me amnesty, or I'm just going to let these people start coming across the border, and there's nothing you can do about it.
I know in America, your film, you speak to the relationship that President Obama may have had with Saul Alinsky, his ideas, and you have sort of a voiceover of a character that would be Saul Alinsky. Let's show a little bit of that.
This becomes a contest of power. Now, power has always gone into two areas, those who have money and those who have people. We have nothing but people.
One thing I've come to realize is that any positive action for radical social change will have to be focused on the white middle class. For the simple reason that this is where the real power lies.
I make myself clear.
That's the actual Saul Alinsky. What is that showing us?
Well, what that's showing us is that what Alinsky is saying is that you can use, if you will, the power of people to just swarm, in this case, the border, and the American people will be defenseless against us. They won't know what to do about it. It's a form of social and political intimidation. I was at the border myself, Megan, not very long ago, researching this film, and I talked to a border guard, and I said to him, with all the surveillance that our government is doing of its own citizens, why can't we spot people coming across the border? And this guy goes, oh, we spot them. He goes, the problem is when we go to our supervisors and we tell them, look what we see on the camera, what they tell us is, move the camera. In other words, don't show the American people what's coming across the border. And that's a direct quote.